Hi guys, welcome to IQPOP. In this lecture, I will discuss about memory hierarchy, the most important concept in computer science. So what is memory? Memory is a hardware device that can store data program instructions either in temporary or permanently. What are the characteristics of storage devices? So there are five characteristics using what we can say that this is good or this is bad or this is the best. They are the speed, volatility, access method, portability, cost and capacity. What is access time or speed? Access time is the amount of time it takes the processor to read from the memory. Standardized measuring unit is nanosecond. So here are the unit and term in seconds. So millisecond is 10 to the power minus 3. That means 1 by 1000 second is millisecond. Microsecond is 10 to the power minus 6 second. Nanosecond is 10 to the power minus 9 second. Picosecond is 10 to the power minus 12 second. Now, what are the basic unit of measurement? Basic unit of measurement is bit. So bit is nothing but binary digits. So it comes as like this, bi for binary, from digit it is t, it together becomes bit. There is only two bit, 0 and 1. So 1 means on and 0 means off for computer. Now after bit it comes byte. So byte means 8 bit together cause byte. Okay, so on these bits and bytes I had a detailed discussion in on a previous lecture on binary number system. Now here is the size of the standardized size of memory we use. So bit is only 1 0 or 1. Then comes nibble, 4 bit together because nibble. Then comes byte, 8 bit together. Next kilobyte, 1024 byte together called a kilobyte, or 2 to the power 10 byte, 2 to the power 20 byte called megabyte, 2 to the power 30 byte called gigabyte, 2 to the power 40 byte called terabyte, 2 to the power 50 byte called petabyte, 2 to the power 60 byte called hexabyte, 2 to the power 70 byte called zettabyte, 2 to the power 80 byte called yottabyte. So nowadays terabyte, petabytes are quite popular, and gigabyte also. Now if you look at the story, how processor is going to be access your data. Well, as you all know that in our computer or laptop or even in our mobile phones, there is a memory storage, right? In case of laptop or computers, it is hard disk. In case of your mobile, you call it internal storage. Now, it comes here basically, okay? And there is a processor, you all know. Now, question is that, a problem arises here, that CPU is having huge data processing speed, okay? But our memory devices like hard disks or internal memories, they are having very low capability or capability to allow processor to read data at this high speed. Okay, so it can't cater the speed of processor. It can't synchronize with the processor speed. Okay, so if the processor wants to read every data from the secondary memory or hard disk, then the processor have to wait every time to get data and write back the processed data. So for handling the situation, inside processor there is registers are the almost of same you can say speed of processor. They are having the same speed, so they can cater. Okay, but problem is that as a register resides inside the processor, so we can't have a huge amount of register, and this is very costly also. Okay, so we usually have 64 bits of register, 32 bits of registers. Okay, so another alternative came, or that is L1 cache. There another, that is, that is cache memory or memory device, again resides into the CPU. Still again the same problem, as it is residing in the CPU, we can't have huge amounts of gigabytes of cache, because again it is a costly and it needs some size or space in the processor. Okay, so still that we usually have, you know, standardized i9 processor are having 13 MB of cache. So it is, again we are calculating MB, so again that cache is not enough to store all the process data and supply the data to the processor. So next thing comes, that is L2 cache. So L2 cache is somewhat almost double or triple size of the L1 cache, which is embedded on the motherboard, and it is very near to the processor slot, so that this L1 cache and L2 cache can communicate very easily and share their data. Now this is having somewhat higher speed than your secondary memories or RAM also. Now we can have RAM somehow beat up higher size, like say 4 GB RAM, 16 GB RAM we can have, so gigabytes of RAM we can have, but again RAMs are volatile memory and we can't use RAM as a ROM, because we can't use ROM as a RAM, because in RAM we need to swap the data every time. So if it is going to swap the data every time, then it is going to be again a problem for processor. Okay, so RAM is having higher speed but less than the cache memory, and but higher than the secondary or hard disks and all. Okay, next it RAM communicates, RAM gets the data from the hard disks, and RAM can swap data from the hard disks to RAM or RAM to hard disks. So this is the way the computer or CPU going to access data, and finally we don't realize that we have a low speed hard disks and high speed processor. It synchronizes the thing in this hierarchy, so this is called memory hierarchy. Here I have summarized the thing. So registers residing in the CPU, they are very fast, they can work less than 1 nanosecond speed, and it is having, say if there is 16 core processor, then we can have 16 × 64 bits of register. So you can see the amount of register is in bit, but very costly, it reside inside the CPU. Then comes cache memory. Again, cache memory is very fast, it is embedded on the motherboard, it can work with less than 10 nanosecond speed. L1 cache can have 32 KB, you can see here. L3 or L2 cache can have 8 MB speed and 8 MB size, and this can be the speed, and it is very costly. Now RAM, it can work with less than 100 nanosecond speed, data access speed, right? Now this is the speed, we usually have 8 to 64 GB of RAM, it is again costly. Then comes SSD, solid state devices, which can work almost same speed of RAM, but it is having a limitation of size, because it is very costly. Even nowadays standard SSD, if you want to low speed SSD, if you want to purchase a Samsung 250 GB SSD, I think it will cost you 5,000. So 1 TB, you can imagine how it is going to be. But as compared to that, HDD is a low cost or cheap product. It is having slow speed than all of these, but it works with less than 10 millisecond speed. Okay, then not micro, it is millisecond. Okay, so you can understand how the speed drops on when we use hard disks. Okay, usually 1 TB hard disks are very popular nowadays. Now offline storage, they are very slow in second, they were, but we can have offline storage in term of petabytes, very cheap. So magnetic tapes and yes, magnetic tapes are mainly used here as offline storage. There is external cache and internal cache. Internal cache, you can see it is residing inside the processor. External caches are embedded on the motherboard. RAM, or random access memory. Random access memory means direct access to any part of the memory. We don't need to go throughout any sequence or any sequence is not there. Randomly you can go any point on the memory space. Our volatile memories, so lost information once the power is off. Used as our temporary storage, typical range is 256 MB to 16 GB. RAM is packaged as chip. RAM chips are coming. So there is two kind of RAM popularly known, that is DRAM, dynamic RAM, and static RAM, SRAM. ROM is read-only memory, that is non-volatile memory. Once you have saved the data in ROM, it is going to be stored for a long time. Generically, it is called as ROM. It is name is read-only memory. Misleading because ROMs can be read and modified. So it is not read only, read and write only, you can say. So SSD and HD, we can read and write to what that thing we can do, but they are ROM. Other example of ROM are CD, DVD, blue chip, and ROM chip is also there. Like our BIOS is stored in the motherboard, that is a ROM chip. Types of ROM: programmable ROM or PROM. What I was speaking about the BIOS, that is programmable ROM. Erasable programmable ROM, EPROM. Electrical erasable ROM, EEPROM. Flash memory or pen drive. Digital devices, right? Most important use is firmware. Program instructions used frequently are going to be stored in some ROM, and from there it is going to be executed. Program stored in a ROM is called firmware. So boot time choice code like BIOS I was speaking about, graphics card, disk controllers are all in some ROM. Now another term you will heard about, that is virtual memory. So what is virtual memory? If you are having less amount of RAM, so all the data at the time of processing cannot be stored into that RAM, so it will need some more space. So what happens, less is data are going to be stored in a particular portion of space on hard disks, but processor things, that is that data is stored in RAM. So as this is not on RAM but on hard disks, but processor thinks that it is on RAM, we call this space as virtual memory. So storage versus memory keep information for a shorter period of time, usually volatile, faster, more expensive, right? But if we think of storage like hard disks, information is retained for longer period, but it is slower and cheaper. Categories of storage: there is magnetic storage, floppy disks, zip disk, hard disk drives, optical CD-ROM, DVD, etc. Solid state devices, USB key and pen drive, etc. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share and subscribe, and hang on with me to get more information like this. Thank you.